Welcome to the CorpVault channel. In this video, we will discuss about horizontal scaling of DDBs. Horizontal scaling, also called scaling out, refers to adding additional nodes or machines to your infrastructure to cope with new demands. In our case, it is the deduplication databases. With this option enabled, the DDB is scaled out, that is added with additional partitions to cope with threshold limits. To enable the option, go to Control Panel. Select Media Management. From under Media Management Configuration window, select Deduplication tab. Enable the option, Enable Horizontal Scaling of DDBs, by changing the value from 0 to 1. Please note, when you create a storage pool with deduplication, if Media Agent is on Service Pack 14, or an earlier version, then horizontal scaling does not apply for the copy. When you enable horizontal scaling, the software regularly monitors the DDBs that exist before and after enabling the horizontal scaling. The software marks a DDB as full upon reaching the system threshold limits, and then stops association of any new subclients to the DDB. However, the existing subclients still back up to the current DDB. Let's discuss how this works. When you create a storage pool with deduplication, the software creates a DDB with the name, storage pool name underscore, DDB store ID. When you perform a backup operation for a subclient, the software renames the DDB to, storage pool name underscore, subclient data type underscore, DDB store ID. The value of subclient data type is files for file system agents, VMs for virtual machines, and databases for databases. The software also renames the DDBs that exist before you enable horizontal scaling. However, the existing subclients of all data types still back up to the renamed current DDB. When you perform a backup operation for a subclient of different data type, the software creates a new DDB for the data type. Any new subclients are associated to a DDB, is based on their data type. When a DDB of a data type is marked full, upon reaching the system threshold limits, the software automatically creates a new DDB for the data type, and associates any new subclients of the data type to the new DDB. Let's discuss with an example. Say you have 100 subclients assigned to a DDB with horizontal scaling. Then you end up with something like this. Let's say you have 100 subclients, all doing file system backups. At this time, say your environment goes over the Q&I time threshold, so the system now looks like this. Now, when you create a new subclient, it will write into DDB file 2, but the original file is still active. This is because the original 100 subclients are still using file, and all your new subclients are going to be using file 2. If you were to seal DDB underscore 1 underscore file, a new DDB would be created called DDB underscore 1 underscore file 3, and it would have the original 100 subclients using it. They would not move into file 2. In this case, you can use a workflow to move clients around from one DDB to another. Horizontal scaling improves deduplication efficiency, because similar data types deduplicate more efficiently than dissimilar data types. You can review and update values for the threshold parameters in the Media Management Configuration, Deduplication tab. DDB Horizontal Scaling Threshold Free Space Percentage. This parameter specifies the threshold for the percentage of free space that must be available on a deduplication database partition disk. When the available free space falls below this threshold, the software creates a new deduplication database. The values range from 0 to 50. The other parameter is DDB horizontal scaling threshold number of subclients per DDB. This parameter specifies the threshold for the number of subclients that are associated with a DDB, after which the software creates a new DDB for the storage policy copy. The default value is 0, but you can set a value other than 0 for the parameter to take effect. DDB horizontal scaling threshold the number of primary entries per DDB is 800 million. So, when the average number of primary records available on a DDB partition disk reaches the threshold of 800 million, the software creates a new DDB. Let's discuss about DDB horizontal scaling queue and I threshold time. The average query and insert time to reach 1000 microsecond threshold is 30 days. The average number of primary records available on a DDB partition disk should be 200 million or more. When the average queue and I time exceeds the threshold and the average number of primary records is above 200 million per partition, then the software creates a new DDB. Please note, any new sub-clients, from the client computers with Service Pack 14, and more recent service packs, associate to the new DDB, that are created with horizontal scaling for backups. The existing, and any new sub-clients from the client computers, with Service Pack 13 and earlier service packs, continue to use the earlier DDB for backups. The software performs a periodic weekly check on the full DDB. When the number of records in the full DDB exceed the system threshold, the software starts associating few sub-clients to the new DDB. You can use Move Clients to New DDB workflow to move the sub-clients of a client computer from the previous full DDB to a new DDB created for their data type. From monitoring end, you receive alerts when queue and I time cross certain threshold, that is, when the threshold crosses 600 microsecond in 30 days, the software generates major severity alerts. When the threshold crosses 800 microseconds in 30 days, the software generates critical severity alerts. We will end this video here. Stay tuned to the channel for more videos. Please hit the like button if you like this video, and subscribe to our channel if not already done so. Thank you. Do subscribe for more videos.